Hey guys, what's going on? Well, I know it's been a while since I've done a vlog from the Oval Office, but I thought, well, now it's time to start doing them again. I've gotten some emails from you guys saying you wanted to see me do more vlogs and share some of my knowledge from my 20 years of being a mobile DJ. And once again, if you haven't heard yet, I think I've mentioned this in other videos, but this year, 2023, does mark 20 years since SNDJ Entertainment went into business. So yeah, very exciting, you know, to be able to have been doing this business for 20 years. And, you know, I'm real glad that, that I've had the opportunity to do this, and I'm glad that I could share some things with you, and that's what I want to do. Now, in this particular video, I think it's going to benefit both DJs and brides and grooms, or any wedding professionals who happen to come upon this video. I think you're going to get something out of it. And what I want to talk about in this particular video is wedding reception timelines versus wedding reception order of events. Okay, now what does all that mean? Well, I've been looking on the DJ Ideas Sharing Facebook page and some other Facebook pages for DJs where they've been talking about reception timelines and not staying on time and all this other stuff. And what's my take on that? Well, let me just explain it to you this way, okay? I do not recommend doing a timeline for a wedding reception. Just being honest there, okay? I don't recommend doing a timeline for a wedding reception. And I found over the last 20 years that by setting up a timeline for the wedding reception, it's only going to make things, you know, really stressful for the bride and groom, the other vendors, and really it's just not a good idea for a party, which is what a reception is. Now, you might be thinking, okay, well, doesn't the reception need to be organized and all this other stuff? Well, of course it does. Now, I do agree with setting up a sequence of events for the reception, but I don't believe in putting a timeout by every single event. Like, for example, you know, saying we're going to do the first dance at 7:45, the father-bride dance 7:50, the mother-groom dance 7:55, so on and so on and so on. And the reason for that is because, like I said, it's just going to create stress on the bride and groom and everybody else involved when you're sitting there trying to stay on time. And really, the reception is the time for the bride and groom to be, you know, relaxing and having a good time and enjoying socializing with their friends. They don't need to be worried about staying on a strict time schedule. So that's why I don't recommend setting up a time schedule or a timeline for the reception. Now, when it comes to the reception, the only times that I recommend are a start time, which I tell my brides, that's the time that you want me set up and playing background music. That's not the time that you want to be coming in to the reception, you know, doing your grand entrance or whatever. So the start time is the time that they want me set up and starting background music. Then you want to have a time maybe to have dinner ready, and then an end time for the reception. That's it. Those are the only three times that you need when it comes to the reception, because everything else will fall in place once you roll on through the night. And I tell my brides and grooms that, you know, the reception is going to create its own timeline throughout the evening. A second reason I don't recommend doing a timeline for the reception is simply because, you know, one little glitch is just going to throw everything off, and you're probably not going to run on time anyway. I mean, it's impossible to say that you're going to do the first dance at 7:45, the father-bride dance at 7:50, you know, and so on and so forth. And a lot of DJs have said, well, you know, that's just a kind of give times approximate, you know, on what we're going to do. We never stick to them anyway. And then my question to that is, why even set it up if you're not going to stick to it like that? You don't even try to stick to it. There's no reason for it. And what I do at SNDJ Entertainment when it comes to the reception is that we will type everything up on an organized planner for our brides and grooms with all the events listed. Like, for example, we'll have wedding party introductions. We'll have everybody's name listed. We'll have, you know, the socializing time, the dinner time, cake cutting, bouquet throw, garter toss, you know, all the spotlight dances and everything. We'll have all that stuff listed in the order that the bride and groom want. But we just don't have times listed beside them, like I said, because we don't want our brides and grooms getting stressed out, or our other vendors getting stressed out, or, you know, anybody trying to stay on time for a reception when there's really no reason to. I mean, you know, it's supposed to be laid back and fun and, you know, all that good stuff. So we don't want to do that. So we just set everything up on an organized sequence of events, and that always works out well. And another thing I want to mention, at SNDJ Entertainment, my rule is that I don't announce or do anything unless I personally check with the bride and groom and the other vendors, especially the photographer, to make sure that they're ready. And so, you know, we're not going to do anything anyway unless we've checked with the bride and groom and, you know, the other vendors to make sure that they're ready. So there's really no need to even set up a time schedule to begin with, because we're not going to go by the times anyway. We're going to go by the times of when the bride and groom are ready, when the other vendors are ready. And like I said, you know, if you set everything up on a strict time schedule like that, what if the bride decides she wants to add something in there or take something out or rearrange something? That throws the whole time schedule off balance. But if you just have an organized sequence of events, then, you know, that's not a problem. You don't have to worry about that. So that's what, you know, I recommend to my brides and grooms. And I tell them, you know, there's no reason to set everything up on a strict time schedule. We'll get all their events in throughout the night before the end of the reception. That's not going to be a problem at all. We do it all the time, but we don't have to set up a strict time schedule to be able to do that, because it's only going to add stress and you know make their reception feel more structured than it really needs to be. So again, the only times you need for a wedding reception is just a start time, which is a time you want your DJ there set up and ready to go, a time to have dinner ready, and an end time. That's it. And everything else will fall into place. Now, I do believe that having a time schedule for the the day of and everything up to and including the ceremony is a great idea. I mean, for example, you need to have times, you know, for when you got like hair appointments and that stuff. You know, like maybe the bridesmaids have got to meet at the beauty parlor that morning, or maybe there's a bridesmaid breakfast or something like that, you know, going on, and, you know, tell them times to get to the church, when the ceremony is going to start. All that, I think that's a great idea to have a timeline set up. But once it comes for the time for the reception, again, you don't want to try to set up a strict time schedule and try to stick to that, because that's the last part of the wedding day, and it's the time you really want to be more laid back and let the bride and groom relax and enjoy themselves and have fun. And they really can't do that if they're trying to stay on schedule. So anyway, I hope you've gotten something out of that. That's just my take on that. And in a future video, I will be showing you a sample sequence of events, and we'll talk more about this in further depth in another video. But in the meantime, you guys have a great weekend. Hope you're enjoying yourself. I hope you're loving the time change. You know, the time changed last week and the days are getting longer. I love it. I love daylight saving time. So, you know, that's one of the things that I love more about the spring. So anyway, we'll have gig logs coming up soon. We've got a lot of other things coming up. So until next time, practice and enjoy.